to inside the Empire.
How you guys doing?
We'll wait for your answer. Good. Okay.
Well, let's talk about this.
They're still talking. Let them talk. Sorry.
Really? Oh, I'm so sorry. I can't. That, you don't deserve that.
No. No, you can't borrow money. What are you talking about? You should leave him. No, tell him that the sun and moon rise in his eyes.
Let's talk about this beer. Got some good juju right here.
Good juju.
Kenner, you're bad juju viewer.
One of my favorite West Coast brewing companies, Left Hand Brewing Company. Ale brewed with ginger. This is basically this is good summer beer. Last one, I've been saving this for a while, actually, for you.
Gross.
Gross. Let's do it.
So just 30, I guess summer's gone now, guys.
It's a fun, refreshing beer.
I like ginger. That's good ginger.
Yeah, they use ginger well in this, I think. Mm. So how are you doing?
I'm doing okay. You know,
just working, living, not letting it hold me down.
I am letting it hold me down.
We went to an engagement party last weekend for Ryan Wonderland.
I'm jealous. I miss that guy.
Friend of the podcast. And the main editor on Kindred Spirits, coming out soon on...
Starring Adam Berry and Amy Bruni?
He knows more about it than I do. That's right.
You should know all about this,
Mike. Coming to a place near you. Let's move over slightly, because I didn't level this before. And like you're sort of out of the picture. I wanted this to be fair to you, man.
I wanted me to be more in the picture. Can we do that?
Your big beefy body. Your big beefy body in here. How are you doing, big guy? This one for you, huh?
I'm okay. I have a lot of days off from work.
You went to the Wizard. Let's talk about the Wizarding.
The Wizarding Weekend in Ithaca. We were scheduled for one day, so we went for one day. And it was interesting. It was actually, would have been a lot of fun, I think.
Also, there's more than one day, and you're only there for the one day.
I think there's 3 days, but I don't think all the days have vendors, and it doesn't really make any sense how
that
works.
Was Ithaca Capella there?
No, there's another. There was this group called Icy Voice Stream that was there.
Wow.
And there was actually groups doing songs that they basically did parodies of other songs with Harry Potter stuff in them.
Ooh.
Or and some Ooh, people la, had la. Harry Potter originals, which is kind of cool. There's one they had this like Luna song that they were singing at when I walked by. It was pretty cool. There's a lot of Harry Potter themed stuff that was really well done.
Did like, you get a wand? You get me a wand?
I did not get a wand. We didn't buy anything actually because we didn't really make that much money. So. Unfortunately, we were in a very bad location, and they didn't put us on the map, so that was actually a big downer for us.
But you really liked it. You should have said your booth was covered by an invisibility cloak.
I said we were the room of requirement. That's what I said.
Ooh.
I said we popped up.
Chinese fireball.
We said we popped up. And we did get some good looks, though. A lot of people liked our stuff, and I got a lot of good comments to my costume, which was kind of cool. I usually don't get that, so.
You were a nomad, right? Because you're definitely a nomad.
No, I had my top hat and the Sherlock coat on, and then I did the Breakbills tie underneath, so they all thought I was Hufflepuff guy.
But, and you said, did you tell them to fuck off and then they wear Breakbills and stuff?
And I went like this, and I went, I'm in sex college. I mean, wizard sex college. I mean, wizard college.
And someone came by and cut your hands off.
And then we turned to foxes and made love. But, yeah, and this weekend we're going to...
Also, if you haven't watched The Magicians, watch The Magicians. It's streaming online now for free.
We're going to...
USA.com.
Near Baltimore, Hunt Valley Inn.
What's this festival called you're going to?
The 10th Annual International Fairy Con this year. 10th. International. Like, they don't have this anywhere else, okay? It's not in Bahrain.
I've heard you're the guest of honor.
It's not in Bahrain. It's not in... Paris, France. It's in...
Not in Ottawa, Canada.
Maryland. It's not in Ottawa. Alberta. It's not in any of the other...
What about, like,
Manitoba?
The Virgin Islands.
It's not in the Virgin Islands.
The Falklands?
There might be some virgins there, but it will... Yeah, it's going to be a couple virgins. but also...
Rainy Brook.
Rainy
Brook?
Ryan's not a virgin. Come on.
No, he's got two kids. He's not a virgin. You're gonna see that. I thought you were gonna say. Also, I'm gonna go see Ryan.
Oh no, we're staying with Ryan. We're staying with Ryan.
Look at that.
Yeah. So we don't have to pay for a hotel, which is nice, and we get to see Ryan. So it'll be really cool.
How much stuff are fans gonna break? Just remind him how much of a dick you were to him.
I was the nice one. Obviously, you just called him a virgin, okay?
We didn't call you a virgin, for the record. No one's called a virgin here. Obviously, that's unless your wife is married or something, and like. Virgin birth. Two virgin births.
He's two kids.
He's Jewish, though.
That's why it could happen, because they didn't. No, but it should be really good.
We'll love you, Ryan and Lindsay, by the way.
Yeah, I can't wait to see them. It's going to be really fun.
And, I'm really jealous.
So we're going to be down there.
Tell them I said hi and stuff.
Thursday night, of course. Thursday night.
Give Ryan a full kiss in the mouth for me.
With or without tongue? Just like a weird...
Church tongue.
Oh, okay.
Church tongue.
Okay. And then we're leaving Sunday night after the show and driving all the way back up.
Yeah, that's going to be fun. It's like an 8-hour drive?
No, it's 6. But yeah, I thought it was 8 at first. I'm like, dude, I'm going to get back at like 2 in the morning. I have to have 6 in the morning to get Aiden off on the bus, but it'll be
What are you taking to get down that fast?
Driving. It's 5 hours and 45 minutes.
Do you know what?
I don't know. But that's what the direction is. That's what the direction is. It's not only in Baltimore, by the way. It's North Maryland. So it's a little closer.
I guess it's probably about
to go around.
It's probably about the same height as
Philly. You're going to go around and down to get to Baltimore type thing. It's not quite there. So.
Blame. Yeah, I know.
Luckily. But yeah, otherwise, let's talk about some news, man. Who cares about me? Who cares about you? Who cares about any of this? News.
Well, I was waiting for them to not respond. Yeah.
Me, I do! I care! They all shouted in unison, I care! Like, okay, let's get into it.
We're adding in post, okay?
Andromeda, the Andromeda Initiative has
us. Sign on that? They sign up?
Yes.
I'm ready to go.
In 7 days, they're going to tell us more about it. And I'm in.
So this is a teaser, if I remember. Because it won't be on 7 days when this is posted. So I will try and post a teaser in here. If I remember, let me look the time code real quick. Keep talking.
6:47. You got. Totally not gonna remember that. It was like a really cool teaser with, basically saying like it's. I think they gave it a date at 600 years in the future.
Well, they said the journey will take 600 years.
Yeah,
is what they said.
I think it said like 600 years from now. That's what they said. And so, now in there, are they talking about in the world of regular Mass Effect?
No, well, I think they are because they when they were saying it, they were showing the N7 guy.
Yeah, and with the regular suit.
With his weird collar thing. I don't know what that's about. But like my collar's just lazily hanging on my armor.
What you wear in the moon. They're
and
on the moon.
And possibly Mama Rider, who we have not introduced yet. Who is wearing like a very feminine looking, which I didn't like. I was like, is she not?
It's like, she like looked like she was wearing Ashley Williams.
Yeah, which I didn't like. I like, why isn't she wearing the same color as him? Like, are we gender separated again in the future? What's going on? That's weird. But it was cool. It's the first time they showed like Mama Rider, even though she's in her helmet and all that. It was still because we definitely confirmed the other guy is Papa Rider, the father of the one of the two protagonists you'll be playing.
So why don't you why not have a husband and wife go to the moon together? That's interesting.
And they're just walking. They had like an old moon lander, but otherwise there was no like way for them to get off the moon, which I thought was interesting. Like, is it over the horizon?
Maybe they just walked a long way. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But I still had me interested. I was like, give me a little more. No, nothing. Okay. N7 day.
November 7th is N7 day. N7. So we'll know more then. We'll know more. By the next time we post, actually, so.
Yeah, and I like how they mentioned it was, join us on the 600-year journey to the Andromeda Galaxy.
It was a fun little teaser, and I'm always excited for more news.
It's a great idea. It's a great concept because it then separates this story definitively from the Mass Effect Shepard story, Commander Shepard story that we know.
Unless Shepard's beamed off, turned into particles, and then he's beamed into the Andromeda Galaxy, but it takes 600 years for the light to get there.
Glad you broke that before I did. Thank you. Plus, man, I chose Green Ending anyway, so whatever. Man. I chose Green Ending. He's part machine now.
Robot machine. Still dead.
Robot machine.
He's still alive. His arm.
Robot machine.
What do you say? His arm popped out of the rubble. That's good.
Yeah.
No.
You took Red Ending. I know you did.
By the way, I did all three endings.
Did you get the Green Ending?
Yeah.
I bet you didn't.
Got all of them. All them, dog.
This guy's not good.
I went red, I went blue, I went green.
I can only get all three endings now because I've played multiplayer so much that, like, even if I'm down at 50% of the readiness, I still have over 100% of what I need for troops.
Hashtag humble brag.
Hashtag not humble brag.
Oh, I'm so good!
I actually played a little bit a week and a half ago. I was like, I wonder if he'll still play this. I was like, got into a game right away. I was like, cool, okay.
You would.
And I played some Vulture!
Also, you would do that. What does the Vorcha do? Just
play the Vorcha. The Vorcha, like, they have a couple different classes. But attack, attack. They basically have a murderous melee, and they have no shields and not very much health, but they have health regeneration. So what you have to do is basically there's different methods. Usually you just have to run at the dude really quick and slice him with a melee.
Okay.
But like they also get a flamer skill, so they can like just flamethrow the dude if he's focused on someone else and just go behind him and flamethrow him. But it's mostly just hitting him with melee until they're dead. And not getting shot, because if you do, you're basically dead.
But then you get to be a Vorcha.
But if you do kill a guy, you actually get a boost to your health regeneration. So like if someone's shooting at you and you kill them, then you're like, and then he goes, ah! And then he gets his health back and he can start killing other people.
Yeah, that's something you would
do. It's fun. Vorcha. It's basically like a paper cannon. Like a scrapper, if you will.
Like a paper tiger?
Yeah, paper tiger. We should listen to that song. No, it's Spirit of Planes, isn't it?
No, Paper Tiger's the song by Thrice. It's just screaming.
That would make sense for a Vorcha. Okay, but yeah, let's keep going. How about we talk about Matt? In the next installment of Tomb Raider, is that going to be called The Shadow of the Tomb Raider?
Oh, shit. We like all have all the same news.
So though. So there's some creeper was creeping on a dude.
Maybe.
And he was basically like...
A Reddit user.
And he's just looking over the guy's shoulder and took a picture of his laptop. And I guess the guy was working on... Possibly the next installment of Tomb Raider.
This was a Montreal train station, I guess. And
that and it's pronounced Montreal.
Montreal.
Yeah,
that's like French. Uh-huh. But they have is a picture of a laptop. They don't. I mean, the guy could have named his laptop.
But yet we both put it as news, man.
Could have named his laptop Shadow of the Tomb Raider.
But on the laptop, it was a logo. It was a logo, a clear logo on it.
Yeah, but he could have made it himself. Who know? We don't know that that's the actual logo. I don't know.
Or do we know it's perfect?
It's just a rumor this time. I love the Tomb Raider series. I wish I haven't played the second one yet because they only put out for Xbox One first.
Did you really love it then?
I like the first one was great. Oh, I like the reboot a lot better than I like the old one. So.
So you like just watching her like get stabbed in the neck?
Dog just eating her over and over. Or wolves.
Ripping her throat out, yeah. You heard it here first, Donald Trump. Watch your mom get tortured.
And I'll have Mexico pay for it!
He did. He did.
Just a rumor at this time, though. I mean, that's really... I guess they'll tell us later. Maybe they'll change it just
only
to mess
time him. Will tell.
That
was quick. Okay.
Yeah. Con Man the Game, Mike?
Why are we talking about... We were talking about Con Man the Game.
Did we? Yeah. We didn't, I hadn't played it yet, though.
Okay, let's talk about it then, man.
Let's talk about it, man. It was great. Was it the best mobile app ever, or...
It's not better than Legend of Heroopolis, but sure.
Oh, the graphics are way better. No, really. I get to be Ray's friend now. Like, I help him out.
How many little helper dudes do you have?
I only have two so far.
Do you have the hero guys?
I have Joss Whedon.
No, the hero guys.
And I have Kevin Smith. I only have two. I have two cosplay guys. I have four. I have the chick and then the one dude whose name is like...
They made some new guys already, too. They didn't have them when I first played, so I have to get those guys to it.
So you got, maybe you'll go back, maybe not.
We have to go back!
But, yeah, it was...
So how much do you like it on a scale of 1 to 10?
I'd say 6.
So how did you just discover this game, by the way?
It came up on my Facebook feed, and I was like, oh. I heard about it, but I didn't realize it was out yet.
Yeah, we were notified, you know, us backers of the Con Man movie.
I backed it too. I just must not have been paying attention.
I guess, yeah. Because yeah, they told us about it. They said, hey, play the game. It's free to download.
Play the game, read the story. And you did.
I did. I read the story. Ray Nearly. Con Man 2 is still in production, though. I don't think they wrapped yet, but it's going to happen.
Well, you know, you did good with Con Man 1. Now you got a budget. Keep going. Keep doing it.
I'm looking for a little more Allison Hayslip, please.
Or a lot more Allison Hayslip.
There's an original Kickstarter. How about this one, Matt?
Okay.
Let's talk about this. James Cameron wants glasses-free 3D for the next Avatar.
How can that happen?
It can't. It's his pipe dream. He has not said how he wants
it. Is there like 8,000 cameras just beam the images in all at the same time?
He wants movies to be way too expensive for us to actually go to so that he can do Avatar. He also wants higher frame rates to support this kind of feature. For his new Avatar movie. So he's still He's still no word on if he'll finish this movie. Is what I put because there's not. But he's still his main complaint was that he wants brighter 3D, and which is why he wants the no glasses, because he thinks the glasses are, like the polarization effect is what dims the 3D.
I don't care about any of the Avatar movies. How is it gonna make me care? That's what I really want to know.
Well, Matt,
make me care again.
He's got four of these slated.
I know
four like, Avatar movies,
but he had one good. It was a good movie. For what it was worth. There's a lot of crappy points in it.
A lot of things stolen from other movies, sure.
Yeah. It was like if they made Independence Day, they're like, we're going to make 18 more Independence Days. You're like, whoa, slow down. And we're going to make the ships life-size. You're like, no, we don't want to do that either. You're like, why are you doing this? Why is this the rest of your life? I don't.
So Matt, the first one's coming out 2018. So you ready for this?
No.
Y'all ready
for I don't even care. Make me care.
What if part of the movie is you get to be in the Avatar? You get to be like in the blue body.
So you get to have my things connect with
Yeah, and you just like start fucking the horses and everything like that and with your little tail thing. Cause that was a weird thing. Like this is what we have sex with, but it's also like what we ride a horse with. Like that was weird, right? that's a weird thing.
Did you just fuck that horse?
Like, oh, this is means we're fucking. Like, but I'm also doing this to a horse at one point. Like a weird alien horse, not like an actual horse.
Mike, okay. You don't get it. It's not fucking, okay? It's them joining on a spiritual level where they both come.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, the horse is aroused. So
the horse came.
Like, is that why he runs though? He's like, I'll do whatever you want as long as you keep this feeling coming. Yeah.
You can't fight the feeling anymore.
You know what? I think we're onto something here.
I'm glad we don't have to ride a horse by sticking
also,
our penis in it.
There is a porn version of Avatar, and it's horrible.
I'm sure there is.
It's horrible. I've seen it.
Horrible. I've seen the whole thing. Yeah. We're going to review it, actually.
Yeah, I've seen it as an academic thing. It's an academic thing.
I was wearing a pair of a monocle and one of those hats.
I had a little pad, a little scratch pad. I drew some notes. Got some pictures, some positions. We'll do a review of it for next.
We'll do
this. No, I don't recommend. Unless you're really into, like, Avatar. Then it's great.
And it gets you, like, really horny.
Yeah, like the movie Avatar gets really
horny. Wait, do they tangle their things in the movie?
No, it's just his penis. And
oh, that's lame.
This blue paint all
come
over.
Come on.
Blue paint. No, that's what they did.
Lame.
That's what they did. Just come on.
How lame? You should at least, like, pretend
that blue paint all over the place. It was ridiculous.
Well, I mean, it's not the real skin color. That's what you gotta go with. Okay, so Rick Famuyiwa.
It seems like you made that up.
Rick Famuyiwa was the second director slated for the Flash movie after Seth Smith left. And now he's gone and left too. What's going on with this Flash movie, Mike?
What's going on is that Flash movie is still a horrible idea.
So supposedly Rick left for creative differences. He wanted the movie to be much edgier than the studio wanted it to be, and they couldn't come to terms on it.
What? And the reason the studio doesn't want this one to be edgy is because all the rest are so edgy, and because the success of the Flash show, which is a very campy, fun show.
Yeah.
And what's funny is they did agree to edgy at first when they were going with all edgy for all those
shows. Zack Snyder smashing to.
And then because of the not really success.
Batman vs Superman.
The not really success of toys smashing together, they decided that like maybe because the Flash show is doing so well, maybe they should go that direction.
Flash vs Flash.
It's very confusing to a director that like is like, oh well, your other shows are this way. How's this going to fit into your world? You know.
I don't know. So this Flash, so basically Ezra Miller, we're doing a Grant Gustin impression. That's what we have to guess.
Just move Grant Gustin over.
The filming of this is most likely going to be postponed because Ezra Miller is already in commitments to film in July. And this was supposed to start filming in a couple months, and now it would be too close of a commitment.
Oh, no.
So unless they get a director like tomorrow and start doing this, then...
Hey, Ezra's getting paid. Good for you, buddy. Keep on keeping on, man.
He's doing something else where he's not that interesting. But
he's like, I'm playing a cancer patient who falls in love in a Nicholas Sparks movie.
They couldn't get Ansel Elgort because he's too big now.
Andrew Garfield's schedule didn't line up.
That's all I got, dude.
Well, Matt, I have at least two more things. So Here's the one that you're not going to care about, but I'll actually know three more things. Okay, so I'll get the one you don't care about out of the way first.
Okay, good.
Matt, will Sombra be formally introduced to BlizzCon? Do you understand what I said at all?
Sombra Fair is everywhere.
So Sombra is possibly the new character for Overwatch. So far, Overwatch has done four characters, one for each class, and now they may be starting a new round of characters, which is great, because they always... If you haven't played Overwatch, which you haven't, because you're a piece of shit...
That's true. That all tracks.
Just didn't need that. There's different classes, but all the characters have play very differently, and it's a lot of fun because of that. Sombra looks to be like some kind of hacktivist type character, so I'm not sure if she can like hack other characters in some way, or if that just makes her like shoot different lasers out of her different fingers than someone else. Who the heck knows? But they're hinting heavily that she will be introduced at BlizzCon, which is Blizzard, the people,
yeah,
kind of the develop, not developers,
it's
but
actually a convention for producers. People who love Blizzards.
For cold, the Blizzard cold at enthusiasts, like at yeah. like a DQ, like the DQ Blizzard.
Oh yeah.
I hope they serve those at BlizzCon.
Yeah, Blizzard
get on this Dairy Queen. What you're missing out?
Some
great cross branding. Oh.
But yeah, we talked about her being kind of teased in some artwork and stuff, and now they've put some formal artwork out there and a formal story for her.
Does she look good?
Yeah, well, of course she's sexy. I mean, you can't be ugly.
Is it when she is her finishing pose like her sticking her butt out and going?
No, it's just Tracer. What's nice about
oh, she's like holding her ankles.
This is Overwatch. They do have different nationalities and different body types. So it's not just like it's like a sexy chubby girl, a sexy tall girl, and a sexy.
Where's
girl.
The ugly girl?
Is there? Well, there's an older woman, but she's not really ugly. She actually looks. She doesn't have any wrinkles or anything either. She just has gray hair. And you're like,
she's old.
Chick. And she's actually the mother of another character.
She's super old and super hot.
And there's like the cool guy with the skull mask, or you can be like the cool guy with the armor on, or you can be the cool guy with the cowboy hat on. So you can be any kind of cool guy you want. Like, name a cool guy right now.
Fireman?
You can be a fire. Well, actually, May is the fire. She has a fire outfit, and although she only.
I want to be a man who does fire stuff.
Well, there's Zendaya. He doesn't really do fire stuff. She's a monk. She's a robo monk.
Nothing to do with what I was talking about.
She's a robo monk. I don't play.
He's a monkey with the fire hat.
Like no, pretty much. Yeah, it's pretty much. That's racist, man. Racist.
What else you got?
So that one's done.
I'm doing great. This is.
This
might be our best one ever.
It definitely is the best one. So Matt, Millie, we're gonna
Millie Vanilli Brown,
Netflix.
Millie Vanilli Brown.
So Millie Bobby Brown, the adorable little 11-year-old girl who plays 11, and now she's 12 or 13 now. They said that there's a rumor that she will be back for Stranger Things, but the Duffer Brothers have not confirmed yet. They basically said that it's undecided whether we'll bring her back.
She's back.
They're smart. They're gonna bring her back. But now there's like a strong pull towards. Are you watching Westworld yet, by the way? Because there's another thing I want to talk about.
No.
With you that I can't because you don't watch Westworld.
I'm trying to get Jess to watch it as our next show because we finished.
You're hurting my.
Because we finished The Expanse, which should be your next show, by the way. Get on there, get on your list.
No, I have time. We'll watch Westworld.
Oh, we got time.
Westworld.
You watch one episode a week.
Westworld's good.
I can catch up.
I'm
when I catch up, then I will have much more shows.
If you catch up, Matt, we can talk about it because there is something awesome that is going on that I have figured out before. I figured out before they announced it, which makes me feel a little pride inside, a swell of pride. But So last thing, Matt. Let's do the last thing because we're almost done with this. The home stretch. Netflix. So Matt, Netflix has borrowed $800 million. To do some more original programming.
Oh, that's great. They did some really good Adam Sandler movies, and they have a Kevin James original coming out, so that's going to be fantastic.
So, Matt, the bad news is that now this puts them...
No, I already said the bad news, but keep going.
$2 billion worth of debt.
Yeah, because they made Adam Sandler movies.
So are they getting in trouble with this? Do you think that this...
No, I think they have a long game on this.
Or do you think this is just to be like...
Could you imagine Netflix closing? I think there would be like a million screams.
I was thinking more like them like raising the prices like by double or something. They're like, oh, it's $30 now.
They already started inching the price up a little.
What I'm saying, like that they're already doing that. But do you think there'll be a big jump if they have to like their bank's gonna foreclose them for some reason?
You know, maybe they're trying to get people so hooked that they can charge them $30.
Or are they just gonna do the Trump where they just don't pay them back?
$30 is still less than paying for cable. You know, so.
And see, that's what I'm afraid of. And then they'll be like, well, $60 is still less than cable, too. Now that we have you over here, $70 is less than cable.
They might have to. Maybe they're realizing that cable had to charge that much, you know. I don't know.
But I don't like it.
I don't like it either. Because cable makes less Kevin James movies. How dare you, Netflix?
Well, that's because Kevin James is on CBS, Matt.
Yeah, and he's on fire right now. His career is regarding Kevin. That'd be awesome if it was a Regarding Henry TV show.
Oh, Regarding Henry.
He was like Harrison Ford character.
He has a remake.
Yeah.
He's like, hey, guys, look at my hot wife. I have a hot wife, and she never listens.
Remember, I already had this show.
I am so hot and young.
He already had this show.
I'm hot and
Did
young.
Did he have this, like, Everybody Loves Kevin or something like
I'm
that?
I'm both hot Kevin, and young.
Kevin, King of Queens, this is what it was. King of Queens. He already had this damn
show. Yeah,
but
she's too old now. She's too old to be
his
wife.
He's like, Leah Remini's an uggo now. Next, give me a younger chick.
Hi, I'm just out of college, and we're somehow married.
What? For 10 years.
Gross. Why?
Because Kevin James sold his soul to the devil. We've already talked about this today.
Yeah, Adam Sandler. He sold his soul to Adam Sandler.
Apple Doobie, give me your soul. That's all I request. I sure as ever have.
Make me a movie star. It worked for me. It's me, Rob Schneider. Look, I'm doing a voice.
I'm doing a racist voice.
That's all I do.
My last name's Schneider, but I'm playing a Mexican, a Native American,
a guy in blackface. No, please, Rob, stop.
That's really, yeah.
Stop. Why? Now that we depressed you guys.
Yeah, thanks. I'm depressed myself.
Stay classy.
Fang, fang, fum.
Bye, everyone. Have a good night. 27 minutes, wow.
So...